Welcome to the BIM Corner channel, and I'm Chris from RunGrasshopper.com, and in this video I will continue your favorite series about data tree structure. It's extremely easy to mess up with the data tree structure, especially if a user doesn't know what he or she is doing, just chaotically grafting, fluttering, and simplifying to the point of accidentally achieving the desired result. However, just sticking to some straightforward rules can result in a fewer problems with data tree structure. Here is my list of good habits of how to deal with data trees. Panel and param viewer. This one maybe will be obvious for many of you. Of course, panel and param viewer will be helpful to check your data tree structure. Many transformations or modifications on a list expand depth of a path structure. What does it mean and why it's like that? Look at this example. Curve divide component. As an input on the left side, we give single items in the list, one curve and the division number. In the curly bracket, you can see 1, 0 in both lists. When you hover over the points output of the divide curve component, you can see that the output will be represented in the list form, points as a list. Not every component does that. However, the divide curve is one of them. It means that Grasshopper will create a whole new list. If we look at data now, we will see 2 zeros in the curly bracket. The initial zero represents the original list, and the second zero corresponds to a newly created path. Okay, you can say that this structure with many zeros is unnecessary. It should be just 1 0 there. However, it would be the best if you look at what happened right now. We changed the input data from 1 item to 3. And now you can see the difference. First of all, we have a dashed wire from the output, which means that we are dealing with a data tree structure. Second, we can see that the number of items from the original list jump into new paths. So the first item corresponds to the first path, the second item to the second path, and so on. Remember that we still have the initial zero before the new path number. These zeros are not unnecessarily garbage as many people think. It tells a lot about the history of a data tree structure, and working on complex data will be impossible without these zeros. Conclusion is, it is always wise to follow how the structure is changing upstream and be aware of all changes. Some of the components output will be presented in more straightforward form. Let's check the extrude component, for example. As an input, we have several lines and one vector, all in one list. If you hover over the output, you will see extrusion result. Not in the list form as it was before. That's why Grasshopper will not create other paths, or that all data will be placed in the original list structure. So it is crucial to be aware that some components make an additional path and some do not. And one more thing. With Param Viewer, you can visualize how the data tree structure looks like. You can find it in params and util, and connect to this component your data tree. You can see how many branches and how many elements are in your data tree structure. When you double-click, a visualization of a data tree will appear. When you work with a lot of data, it is wise to use a param viewer because you will get a good overview of how data is structured. Try to use as little as possible these operations. Simplification of a tree and flatten operation. I know that in many cases, this is the easiest way of doing some operations. Simply flatten the whole tree and everything will work properly, right? I have to admit that sometimes I overuse these operations just to get and see the results as soon as possible. And it looks like natural because you are trimming unnecessary zeros in your data tree. However, afterwards, I forget about it, which can cause a lot of trouble, especially when it comes to merging lists. As I told you before, those extra zeros are essential and can contain helpful information and prevent additional variability in your path. Maybe in a simple script, and just for one case, it is just not a problem at all. if you exactly know what your input will be, node branching can be a solution as well. However, I suppose you are going to create clusters or programs that can solve many cases. Not just copying part of a script several times and do the same thing on a simple data and merge afterwards. Grasshopper manages complex data pretty well, and input can be presented in a form of data tree. In that case, you have to avoid flattening and simplification and systematically make branching. Why? Because when you are going to work with more advanced data tree structure, this operation will destroy the whole system without any mercy. Number 3. Shift paths. Alright, Chris, but what if I would like to create a script and I'm uncertain what input data will be? What should I do instead of flattening or simplification? Try to use a shift path as much as possible. This component allows you to restore previous information about data tree structure. Use these components whenever you need to go to your latest data structure. Shifting paths work like shifting lists. However, here we shift the indices in all data tree paths. Offset to apply to each branch in an integer form. The offset value can be positive or negative, and negative number give a result similar to the trim tree component. Shift path by a negative value is like trim tree with a positive value. Still, I don't know the reason why Grasshopper has two similar components. Let's go to an example. Positive numbers approach the data tree differently. The component reorders the data tree based on the smallest branch in a tree. For example, 0 semicolon 0 semicolon 0 and 0 semicolon 3 semicolon 0, both structures end with a 0, with offset 2 are combined into just one branch 0. The shift path option looks a bit like a control flatten option. It allows you to move the data one or more branches lower or to collapse the data into a single branch similar to the flatten option. However, now place on a single branch. One more extra helpful component. Based on the guide tree, you can unflatten a tree. This is useful if you need to change certain values based on the pattern that should continue no matter the branch an item is on. So if you have to make some operation on a flattened data list, do it. However, use unflattened components with the guided tree structure afterwards. Flattened data tree makes operation what you need and restore tree with unflattened component again. In other words, we can say that unflattening a data tree is like moving items back into original branches. If you would like to learn and read more about Grasshopper, I have prepared a free Grasshopper guide. 20 pages filled with books, exercise and tutorials about Grasshopper. Everyone will find something for themselves. To download the guide, please click the link in the description below. Number 4. Use tree explode and path mapper wisely. In one of my previous episodes, I recommended using path mapper as much as it possible. You can find the link to the video somewhere in the upper corner. However, at the end of a movie I presented flaws of a component. Namely, if any changes in the source tree happens, then the component will stop working. Any simplification operation before the path mapper will block the component. That's why you have to be very precise in all changes and know how your data is structured. The same happens with explode tree component. Every time a tree structure changes, the component will stop working and cause a lot of trouble. So the recommendation is to design your script as though the upper stream tree structure is not going to change at all. Use the shift paths component that I presented in the previous point. In this case, you will prevent your data from changing. You can also program several rules in the path mapper component as shown on the screen right now. However, I recommend keeping your path in order. So using these two components will not be a problem at all. Do you know more components that are not recommended to use with changed data tree structure? Write in the comments below. Number 5. Don't mix. All lists that will talk to each other should have the same number of items. This is a simple general rule that will help you to work with Grasshopper. There is just one case when it's not a problem while dealing with different numbers of items. When one of the list consists of just one item, then Grasshopper will automatically connect this one element with the rest, based on the longest list matching. Nevertheless, I will anyway recommend transforming this list with one item into the list that will have the same number of elements. For that operation, you can use the longest list matching, just to be aware of what you are doing. I recommend that for all beginners who are new to the data tree. That was about lists and items. However, this rule should be also applied to the branches. Again, the best is when you are working on the data with the same structure, the same length. So in the one data tree, you have the same number of branches as in the other one. You can obtain that by tree operation like graph, shift tree or pathmapper. As with lists, the principle will also operate on the tree structure when one of the tree has just a one branch. However, this branch should be on a branches with different number of items. Conclusion is, don't mix the number of branches because you can find yourself at the point where there is no possibility of connecting some lists because items are in a different branches. And the last but not least, check what you are merging. Again, general rule, hold the path lengths of branches the same in your whole data structure. You can have a different numbers of items, as you can see now, in each branch. This is okay, and in many cases it will be like that. But look closely into the branch index. The path lengths of branches should be the same. If you find one with a different number, something went wrong and needed to be fixed immediately, primarily because of problems with merging together with other lists afterwards. To be updated and to learn all secrets and Grasshopper components, join our community. It's easy. Go to learngrasshopper.com, click the join button, write your email address and click the confirmation link in the email you will get from me. Every week you will be getting all the latest videos, learning materials and inspiring links about Grasshopper directly to your inbox. That's all for today. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Have a good one.